bruise at the base of my spine is butterfly shaped. Dressed and downstairs, my mother's eyes flinch away from the skinniness I'm oblivious to. Blank haired, skin splotched with bruises like spilt wine. Something like drunken strangers trying to lock their eyes onto a body that's slowly disappearing. Sitting, curled in on myself, the centre of this, there must be a sort of purity. I just work myself in a little deeper. Bones that catch the cold and hold it in this point somewhere. Waking, snared in the limbs of someone I never see again. An unfamiliar voice trying to pin me down with sleepless concern. He's slack. Flesh bags round his waist and I repel. I'd do anything not to have to touch. Curling tight around a hook that cuts the bone. Trying to find the centre that must be here somewhere.
Thank you.
pours vice into my eyes and my mouth, and I thought, now I'm away from it all. The air is warm, it's black, smells of vinegar acids, wanting to dissolve to a vapour, to disappear, be ice cold, knife sharp, to cut, to sear, to burn. The light frays my nerves and hurts my eyes, and then it's over. You're ill. I'm drinking this morning. Shiny's beetle shell. I watched it. Meets ahead of me as the afternoon sunlight twitched on and off of you. The swish of your hair, the clothes, the hefty walk also, it isn't you at all. Nonetheless, I'm ruined. And the clatter of my inappropriate shoes on the asphalt spares me on. I'm stunned by the distance between us. The outpost and the clumps of lids that spring like flowers on the pavement. Hollow air clangs my lungs. Sick and dizzy, I finally caught up with someone who's not you at all. I'm not the least bit surprised. Shell. I watched it, moved ahead of me as the afternoon sunlight twitched on and off of you. The switch of your hair, the clothes, the hefty walk or say it isn't you at all. Nonetheless, I'm running, and the clutch of my inappropriate the shoes on the asphalt spurs me on. I'm stung by the distance between us, the lamppost and the clumps of lids that spring like flowers from the pavement. Hollow air climbs my lungs, sick and busy. I found a clock of the sun is not you at all. I'm not the least bit surprised. song lyrics and an oddly sweet aftertaste that comes back to me from time to time. Glint of streetlights, the same brightness and shine sits in the palm of my hand. It's only okay as long as I'm not thinking, and I'm not thinking. It's so sweet, caught in the back of my throat and swimming through my fingers. It curdles over orange plastic, sputters the newspaper, and I'm neither relieved nor disappointed. Sickened and numbed over, yet underneath this, a quick thrill pierces my veins. It sparks a sap of life into me.
Thank you.
thought of the poem with the line about the smoke being a huge yellow cat curling around the house. Clownish figure, measuring out slife and coffee spoons. He said the idea of bondage made him laugh, conjured up an image of some middle-aged couple thinking they'd been a bit risky and trying to spice up their lagging sex lives with an array of contrived and cliched devices. However, with some other's apron strings to hand, I can't imagine him saying no. You say you don't feel fully fledged, and crawl back into the room, too scared to agree or disagree or even think about what you want. You say you're scared of feeling trapped and lock yourself in with this house. Tangled duvet cover and pitched into the entrance. Mixed drinks and sticky sweet taste of vomit clinging to my teeth. Seen trees of dark smelly room. Man and mongrel bondage combed the cracks in the paintwork. Dead mongrel cocoon in the sheets, smear the sweat and makeup. Symbolism out of football matches and nausea. We look drugs and battered. I thought I'm boss of Rosalind, making a nurse in his bed. He measured the trail with something I'd done to him. He caught the 416 back home, leaving me standing on the platform with a squat on my skin and a comb in my hair. Please keep in touch. I couldn't see the pond.